For the sign of Pisces, hello and welcome to my channel. We got the High Priestess, and it's paired with the Emperor. Now, the High Priestess is a spiritual card, very spiritual. It could have some sexual overtones. It can mean that you're in a phase, or you will be in a phase coming up in May, where you're going to be much more physically attractive to others. This card is tied to the moon, to femininity, to inspiration. This is a time to rely on your intuition and your inner knowledge rather than your conscious mind or your intellect. It's also going to be important for you to pay attention to your dreams coming up in May. Keeping a dream diary or a journal, it's going to be a really good idea. So, this High Priestess is paired with the Emperor. Now, the Emperor is very interesting. I hope you can see the picture. Emperor, okay, is about domination over the mind, over the heart, and it's sometimes necessary even though it's not wanted. So sometimes you should welcome this, and that's what you must think about when this card appears in your reading, as it is. Because when hard choices have to be made, it's important to maintain your concentration and focus. The Emperor, it signals this, but it also signals that now is a time, coming up in May, that you'll find it easier to make hard choices. So enjoy the assertiveness and confidence that this self-control and focus brings. Forge ahead and do what you know is best. If you can master yourself, then you should have little problems mastering most of the other obstacles that life can sometimes throw at you. So basically, for the present time, this High Priestess paired with the Emperor is basically saying that coming up in May, it's going to feel like a magical, mystical time for you, for love. You might find that people, they're literally throwing themselves at you. Now, the problem is that you're going to start to attract both, or all kinds, the good, the bad, the ugly, and that's not always easy to tell which is which. So you're going to have the power of femininity at your disposal coming up in May. And at first glance, it'll probably seem great. Yeah, a lot of people will be wanting your attention. A lot of people will be attracted to you, Pisces, coming up in May. Yeah. Yep, you'll be sitting really pretty. That's what the High Priestess does. Now, because it's with this Emperor, you'll be using your head and not your heart. So that's probably a good thing, probably because there'll be so many people wanting your attention. So it's the head is a good thing to use when you got multiples. Yeah, you won't just be falling for anyone. You'll be thinking before you act, which is good. Because like I said, you're going to be attracting a little bit of the whole gamut. Good, bad, ugly, pretty. I'm referring to that movie. I'm not saying people are ugly, but you know that. You probably heard of that movie, The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. So they'll be coming at you all kinds of ways. Now, so you'll be like this Emperor, because the Emperor doesn't use his heart. He only uses his head. And so, like I said, I think it's good. I think that's good because, yeah, you won't just be believing what people tell you. You're going to think about what they said before you take action. Yeah, and you just won't be falling in right away. So that's what we got for you for the present time. let's move on over. Let's take a look at how your person is seeing you. Now, they see you like this King of Cups, and they see you as a tower. The King of Cups is about, well, it speaks of a balance, male and feminine energy. It holds all positive qualities, both masculine, feminine. Often it indicates a man in your life. Usually, if it's referring to a man, this person is, if it's referring to a live person, put it that way. It's referring to a kind and loving man. And just know that when you get this card in your reading, that you're supported by the universe in ways seen and unseen. It's all about kindness and compassion. There's an element of pure and true love in your life, no matter what your situation is. So nurture yourself and allow others to nurture you. So, this is how your person is seeing you. Very loving and supportive. You're warm. They think you're really friendly and you're very tolerant. Yeah, so they also see you as a tower, though. Now, the tower is about trying to hold too tightly to the status quo. It's about rolling with any changes. It's likely that some people, situations that you've counted on as being there for you, they may no longer be there in quite the same way. And it doesn't have to be drastic. Just know that change is the nature of life. So if you try to prevent it, it's going to be like trying to row upstream without a paddle. And if you've been building some castles in the air, this is the time that some might come crashing down to earth. That's only going to be a problem if you let it be. Because you can replace them with some more realistic and reachable dreams and goals. If some of them fall apart coming up in May. Dreaming is important, but it's important to be living in a reality too. So, once again, they see you as this King of Cups and they see you as this Tower card. Yeah, this Tower card. Okay, they see you as, like I said, warm, friendly, tolerant, very balanced and loving. They see you as in a very beautiful way, but something happens and it changes. Yeah, you're enlightened by some disaster, and they see it kind of changed you. Let's go more into this reading, and then this way we could interpret these two cards a little bit better, okay? Now, let's take a look at how you see them. Now, you see them as the Magician and the Knight of Pentacles. The Magician, it signifies new beginnings, great expectations. It reminds us that we have the power to make a difference in a whole lot of ways. Whole lot of ways. Just know that you will not have it all handed to you on a plate, though. You do have the potential to have that plate and a lot of what's on it if you do the magic yourself. Because the Magician is all about action. So if you do nothing, you'll get nothing. And if you don't know what to do, then make sure you do something, because anything is better than nothing. In other words, if you don't try, you will not get. Now, just a side note for some single Pisces out there listening. When you get this Magician card in your reading, as you are, if you're in the market for a new romance, this is a time when you're likely to meet someone new. Because right now, someone out there, somewhere is looking for you, just as you're looking for them. Whether you find them or not, it's going to depend on you, Pisces. So, I usually say don't sit at home expecting Mr. and Mrs. Right to walk up your garden path and knock on your door, because that probably won't happen. But that's all we can do these days. But I guess you can go to the grocery store. Yeah, go to the grocery store a lot. Put your pictures online. Because somebody's out there looking for you, just as you're looking for them, Pisces, single Pisces. So you just need to be making yourself available to be found. Take some pretty pictures. Get one of those pretty lace front wigs and some false eyelashes. Do yourself up. A lot of pictures online and a lot of grocery shopping, I guess. But that's not so cute because you got to put the face mask on. So yeah, online for you Pisces singles. This Magician card is really good. It's about manifestation. It's about having the power. You got the power in your hand. So I just had to say that for Pisces who are single. That was just a little side note for you guys. But back to how you see your person. You see them as this magician, okay? And they could be planning, being very strategic in this connection. And it's with the Knight of Pentacles, so we'll clarify it with this Knight of Pentacles. Knight of Pentacles is about messages. Could be with regards to money, finance. You're likely to finally receive some type of news that you've been waiting on, and it's really good news. This Knight is a very practical card. It tells you to pay attention to the mundane, normal parts of your life. You probably heard the saying before, if you take care of the little things, the big things will fall into place. Well, this Knight of Pentacles, it asks you to look at how you're handling your affairs. So, your person sees... I'm sorry, you see your person as, I hope I said that right, you see your person as a magician and the Knight of Pentacles. You see them as, with the Knight of Pentacles, you see them as very stable, slow and steady, okay? You see them as being very practical. And, yeah, and they're planning. You see them as planning, being strategic. So they want to make things happen in this connection. Okay? Now, just also the magician, it could be a trickster. But because it's with the Knight of Pentacles, which is a really good card, finally receiving good news that you've been waiting on. I wouldn't say a trickster. Not unless he's a really good positive trickster. Nothing negative. So you see them as planning to make a lot of good things happen in this connection. And you see them as stable, or they want to be stable and civil in this connection. Slow and steady. That wins the race. And that's how you see them. Now let's take a look at why it's happening. It's happening because we got this King of Swords here. Now that's interesting because the King of Swords is anything but slow and steady. King of Swords and Ten of Cups. King of Swords, this is considered the narcissist card. Very narcissistic. Opinionated, forceful man. He will, but not always, have hair on the darker end of the spectrum. Could have dark hair, dark eyes, but it could go either way. You may be tempted to think only about how things affect you personally. If this does not represent a man. So it's about considering the feelings of others before you act. It's about a very forceful energy. You may not be able to get this person to change his mind or to do what you want. So you might have to change something major about your behavior, thoughts, and or expectations. Now, it's happening because of the King of Swords, and we'll clarify it with this Ten of Cups here. Ten of Cups is one of the most uplifting cards you can get in a reading. If you're worrying about how a relationship, and you get this Ten of Cups, it's a clear signal that you really don't have anything to worry about, because you and your person, you're on the same page. if you're in a relationship but it hasn't become formal, it has not become formal or committed yet, and you hope that it comes to pass, take heart, it's coming. Don't sabotage things by causing problems where there really aren't any. Nine of Cups is a beautiful card. Everyone wants the Nine of Cups. Everyone wants the Ten of Cups. Did I say Nine of Cups? This is a Ten of Cups. Everyone wants this Ten of Cups. You're even spiritually fulfilled. It's a part of the picture. So it's about happy family life. It goes way beyond that too. It goes towards people that you care about, your parents, siblings, children. Being very fulfilled. And this is one of the reasons why it's happening also. King of Swords and Ten of Cups. So, there's some type of controlling, forceful, opinionated, probably arrogant person in this connection. Or, because we've got the Ten of Cups here, which is a beautiful card, I'm picking up it could be a situation. If it's not a person like this that's in this connection, it's a situation that's causing someone to be this way. Forceful, pushy, arrogant, not very nice. But it's with the Ten of Cups. It's with this dream come true. Ten of Cups is a dream come true. So usually people don't think the King of Swords is a dream come true. So let's go over this reading. So for the present time, we got the High Priestess, okay? We got people drawn to you, they're attracted to you. And then you're being smart about it. You're not using your heart. You're only using your head. Because they're coming at you left, right, front, and back. Just all over the place. They think you're beautiful. And your person sees you as very loving with this King of Cups. Supportive. And you want to give a cup of love. But there's a tower there. So you're enlightened by some disaster. So something comes crashing down and maybe you're not so loving and supportive anymore. Or this disaster makes you loving and supportive. But I'm picking up that the disaster is making you not so supportive anymore. And you see them as wanting to manifest things with you. And they're coming in with positive words with the Knight of Pentacles. But why it's happening, because there's a lot of forceful, narcissistic energy. But then it takes you to the Ten of Cups. So I'm picking up because you got so many people. Looks like you got a lot of people in this reading because so many people are fighting for your attention or wanting to get to know you. So that's why it's a lot of things going on in this reading. Okay, but your person, like I said, they see you as someone that you're dealing with. I'm picking up you're dealing with more than one person. Okay? Because you're the High Priestess. You're dealing with more than one person. That's why this reading is all over the place. So, someone, I'm not going to say they see you. Someone sees you as being warm, friendly, loving, want to offer you a cup of love with the King of Cups. Then something happens and then you're no longer that way. Okay? And then you see someone, I'm not going to say them because you got a lot of people here. You see someone as wanting to manifest a connection with you. And then they're bringing in positive messages, good news. They're saying things that you want to hear. So this is one of the people that are attracted to you. Like I said, you're the High Priestess. People are coming at you. Okay, so you see this person as, like I said, wanting to get to know you, wanting to make things happen. They're sending you positive text messages, okay? But for why it's happening, why you got this narcissistic energy here is because you're cutting out a lot of these people. A lot of these people, they don't fit the bill because you're looking for your Ten of Cups. Okay, You're looking for your happy, you're looking for your end-all, be-all. So there's a lot of things going on here because all these people that are interested in you, they find you beautiful and they're trying to get to know you. Some people are texting you and then they're seeing you as very warm and loving. So you're coming across as beautiful and very friendly. That's what the King of Cups is. That's how they're seeing you, these people. But then a lot of these connections, they become a disaster. Yeah, a lot of them come crashing down. I don't see that you've met anyone interesting yet. This has turned out to be a singles reading. Yeah, singles reading, because you're not using your heart. You're just using your head as that emperor. And then you got the sword here. You're cutting out a lot of people because you're looking for your Ten of Cups. You're looking for the best. Yeah, you're not just settling for anything. But then we got people here wanting to manifest things with you. And they're reaching out by text, talk with the Knight of Pentacles. But you're holding out for your Ten of Cups. That's what that narcissistic energy is. That's you, Pisces. Yeah, this has turned out to be a singles reading. Very interesting. I don't blame you. Hold out for your Ten of Cups because Ten of Cups is a dream come true. Go ahead and use that sword and cut out all this, cut out all the BS. Because right now it looks like that's what you're getting. Some tower moments. And you're just not happy. You're just using your head. You're being very wise. Wise. Wise.